Hi there, this is Ross at Woodfire Power, and this is an update on the construction of the new aquaponic system. And this one is going to be a media system and a floating raft system, and I can now show you some of the features we're putting into it. You can see that the heights of the hoops are the same across the length, and yet if you notice, the land or the dirt to the left is about 3 feet higher than on the far side. So the first thing I'm going to show you today is how we managed to get the hoop house built so that it's all uniform. So the first thing we did was to drive a stake at the far end over there and another stake at the far end up there, and then run a dry line between the two. You could use a water level or a 4 foot level or a 16 foot board with a level on it to get the line leveled. Doesn't really matter how high it is, it just matters that it's level. And then what you do is you measure from the line down to the dirt, and that tells you the height that you have from a level plane right there. So let's say that we measure down on that first lowest PVC rung and it's 40 inches. And then we come to the next one up and we measure 35 inches. Well, there's been a 5-inch change, 40 minus 35. So we would cut 5 inches off of that pipe. We repeat the measurement on each pipe and cut each pipe however many inches it needs to be. By the time we get up to the top one, where the elevation has changed a bunch, we had to cut something like 30 inches off of the PVC. We repeated that on the far side, and in that way, the tops of the hoops come out all uniform, in spite of the fact that the lands changed height by something like 3 feet. The way we put the pipes into the ground and attached them is we just drove some electrical conduit, about 3 foot long lengths, and we drove those into the ground, and then that basically stakes the PVC down. And the whole thing will tie down to the ground a little more securely than that, but that sets the positions of everything. Next, let me come over here. We repeated the dry line in order to set the piers, so we took blocks and laid them out where we wanted them to be for this table and the other table, which I'll describe in a minute. And we ran a dry line, keeping it about 1 inch above the top of where we wanted the blocks to be. And then we dug the dirt or pounded dirt in order to get each block set at the right position and the right elevation. And then after that, it's just a matter of stacking the blocks up. So the construction here is a 2x4 running across, and then 4 2x6s to form the base, 2x12 and a 2x6 walls, and that will be the sump. And then on top of that, we have 4x4s running across to create support for the upper table, and again for 2x6s and 2x12 top, and this will be a constant height floating raft table. Over here we repeated the same thing and leveled the blocks out for the base, and then have a whole bunch of 2x6s and are going to build another 4x16 foot media table, so this will all fill with gravel after we get the liners in. Then we put the fish tank up above. We still have to cut some steps in there. And by putting the tank up here, we gain an advantage that's very nice to have for an aquaponic system, and I'll describe that in a second. What we'll do, this is just a standard fresh water tank. Like if you have a well on your property, it's a 550 gallon water tank, and we'll cut it open. Kind of drew a little bit of a line here, and we'll go back over to there and leave that attached, and then the plastic will bend there like a hinge, making this whole thing a lid that we can open up, and we'll build a platform so it's easy to get up into, look at the fish or net them or whatever you need to do. So then there's a bulkhead fitting on the tank at the top and the bottom, and they're threaded inside and out, and we'll put some pipe just using threads and maybe Teflon tape, but no glues or other things that'll be in the water. And that will carry the water from the fish tank out along with all the fish solids, and they'll come out horizontally inside a pipe that's not there right now, so I'm kind of pretending with the camera, and then down into the gravel media bed. So I'll show you that in a later video. And that's what will bring the water from the fish tank into the aquaponic system. And in this instance, we had to block it up and compact some dirt and fill it all in, and we'll put some straps around the blocks to make them a little more secure than that. They're good, but we'll make them a little better even still. Then the water will come into the media bed and fill up, and with the bell siphon at the far end, we'll get a flood and drain cycle, and the drain will come across into the bottom container, which is the sump. And then we'll have two pumps here. So we made the sump 2 feet longer. So the sump is 18 feet and the raft table is 16 feet. And that leaves us a 2 foot opening where we can put pumps and service things, gain access to things. So we'll put the pumps in here, and one pump will just pump water up into the raft table. And at the far end, it will flow down through a standpipe and maintain constant water height all the time. The other pump will pump water across and up into the fish tank. And because that pump is continuously flowing water into the fish tank, there will be water continuously flowing out of the overflow and down into the media table. And then at the far end, the bell siphon will cause the media table to flood and drain, just like any aquaponic system. So that's how this one is coming together. And we just got the greenhouse covering here, so that will be going up next week sometime. And I'll give you some more details down the road. Have a great day. This is Ross at Wood Fire Power.